discussion for the evening. I'd like to firstly introduce our session moderator. Well, he's somebody who not only revolutionized news coverage, but has also driven change at a very highest level. And one of the most renowned news anchor and journalist himself, we have with us none other than Mr. Arnab Goswami, who's the managing director and the co-founder of upcoming news channel, known which is Republic TV. Yes, sir. Let's have you on the stage as well. A very warm welcome. Can we have a huge round of cheer one more time? Now, he's leading a brigade of some of the very esteemed set of speakers who are going to join him as well. So firstly, I'd like to invite the Chief Operating Officer of ABP News Network Private Limited, a seasoned media, advertising and marketing professional who currently oversees 5 24-hour news channels. Please put your hands together for Mr. Avinash Pandey. Our next speaker is the Chief Executive Officer of the media business of the Sarkar Media Group that includes print dailies, magazines, television, digital, online business, Mr. Pradeep Dwivedi. Moving on to our next speaker, the Chief Executive Officer of the domestic broadcast business of Zee Entertainment Enterprises Limited, who is part of the new corporate structure being brought into the company, we have with us Mr. Puneet Mishra. And our final speaker, ladies and gentlemen, President Revenue of Bennett Coleman and Company Limited, who heads the Mammoth Times of India sales organization. Please put your hands together for Mr. S. Sivakumar. Can we have a huge round of applause for our stellar lineup of speakers, ladies and gentlemen? And with that, let's get the session started. Over to you, sir.
Check. Take over, yeah? Thanks very much. Good to see you all. This is a setup. I'll tell you why. This is the kind of subject I like, because you make up your mind before the debate. And so it says not whether advertisers are doing something wrong, it's what advertisers are doing wrong. So we spend the next 45 minutes convincing ourselves that we are correct. So it's my kind of debate. This is a setup by Madison and Pitch. The second reason it's a setup is because you've given a mic to a guy who's not been on TV for 2.5 months. and you made him the moderator, which means I'm not allowed to express my opinion. And the last reason why it's a setup is, we are launching Republic TV, and we want advertisers on our side. And we want me to sit here and tell you why you're doing everything wrong. This is a complete setup, Sam. Not right. Anyway, let's have some fun. I'm seeing some old friends here, and it's great to be among all of you. Let's debate. Let's disagree. So we'll start with my dear friend Shiva, who's on the other side. We're actually on the same side. Shiva, let me throw it at you. What are advertisers doing wrong? If I were to tell you what advertisers are doing wrong, is print. Print is history. Print is the past. TV and digital is the future. Nobody reads newspapers anymore. So if I were to tell you, Shiva, that print is what advertisers are doing wrong, respond and then we'll debate.
Sure. Thank you, Arnab. Typically, I was telling Sam and Vikram that I don't attend conferences because it's very difficult to speak. So, but they told me that Arnab is going to moderate, so I was very confident that I have nothing to speak.
So, don't dodge the questions, you know.
So that was the kind of preparation I have done. So two things I would like to talk on this point. One is, I believe that gone are the days when we used to get things right. Progressively, we can only get things less wrong. And today, what we are actually facing is a multi-dimension of options which are before us, versus from a linear option to multi-dimensional option. So what does it do? So let me take an analogy, otherwise it's very difficult to talk to Arnab. It's like taking a buffet meal, and because it's a multiplicity of options. So television is like starters. So they have a lot of frequency, lot of items do come before you, and you can always choose based on what is the content. Digital is like desserts, and you don't want to miss it out, and you will have what others are having. It is a network effect. But print, guys, is your main course. Is the one you choose, what you like. It is nutritious, it is healthy, it is your choice. And that, guys, ladies and gentlemen, is the strength of print. And the wholesome nature of print is never going to disappear. It's going to be there for you.
Shivai, last night was Valentine's Day. I went to Hard Rock Cafe with my wife. We only ordered starters. What are you going to do then?
Yes. The whole problem with this new generation, fear of missing out, people are skipping meals, no doubt about it, but they're not good for health.
Let's have a response from the audience. Oh, this is great. This is like the old times. Is it 9 o'clock? Yeah? Wow. Great. Avinash.
You know, a print is not about whatever main course. It's a stale food. You know, something that you have already seen and debated through the upcoming Republic TV.
Thank you.
And all night you have watched the news, different channels, saw it on the digital. Who is interested in getting the same news? The second problem is this, that the young generation, I have a 18-year-old daughter, she often tells me, why the hell, Dad, you buy so many newspapers? Who is going to read it? The generation is changing, and as far as we are concerned in television, the generation will watch on TV, debate on digital, and that's where the life will end. Print will be read only for the intellectual piece written by people, most of them are sitting here. So for that, if the newspaper survives like that, it's better. Otherwise, there is no future.
Okay, this is great. I'd
like to respond to that.
I think
people have been writing epitaphs of print for close to 2 decades now, ever since internet sort of came into existence. Every year, they stand up and say that print's going to die, and there is a new audience coming, which is purely millennial, which is purely digital. I agree with all of that. But that's a very metrocentric, unidimensional view of a country as complex as India. I think people are missing out on the fact that there is a vast majority of Indians who are demographically spread out into locations where digital has not yet made its access felt, where the variety of local content, local news is not available in the language in which they want to consume it. It's all about recognizing that audience. The level of literacy in India, the person when he first becomes literate does not go out and buy a smartphone and start reading Huffington Post one of these apps or even the news site. The cheapest and the most credible access to information and news, even today, for a primary reader is news. Now, you would say that's a subprime audience that may not be relevant to advertisers, but talk to every single marketer sitting here. What is the best means of accessing the newer market opportunities, expanding the pie of the consumers that they want to get into? It is to these rural and newer demographics that are emerging, and print is ideally suited to suit that. I'm not here to defend the brief on print per se. I'm happy to move into television and digital, because as a business group, we do all of that.
One second. The fact is that this is the last solace you're giving yourself, that literacy is growing so people will read. Are you saying people who watch TV or read on digital illiterates?
No, they do. But I'm saying the primary mode of access for a lot of them. So I'm not saying that you need to defend print by virtue of saying that it's a dead medium. It is a medium that has relevance for a large emerging new audience.
No, but the question is, the question when you talk about what advertisers are getting wrong, they're going to talk about the volumes being spent.
Absolutely.
Nobody's saying print, you know, you shouldn't spend any money. I think the principal issue today is, what are advertisers getting wrong? So in the allocations themselves, do you feel in the allocations themselves, we should not read the growth figures of 3%, 4% in print and invest in the future? The question is, what are advertisers getting wrong? Are advertisers getting it wrong if they focus too much on print? That's the question.
Well, I would actually like to say that perhaps they need to take a balanced view of all the mediums available. But even the 3-4% growth in print that you talk about is an average. You can never go with averages. They have to slice the averages to look at which parts of print is growing. There is print which is growing at 13-14%.
Yeah.
That's really in the hinterland of India, and that's where the real opportunity lies.
Yeah.
Metros, in any case, are going to plateau out, and that's, I think, writing on the wall.
Okay.
Nobody needs to tell the marketers that.
Okay.
But it is discovery of the real India beyond the metros that marketers need to wake up.
Okay. Puneet will respond.
Actually, I don't really think what they're getting wrong is whether they're investing in one medium more or less.
I think where advertisers may be getting it wrong, and I must confess, I'm a new convert to the industry, just 4 months old after 20 years of selling soap of a different kind. Started to sell soap of a different kind only 4 months back. So whatever I say, take it with a pinch of salt. But I think what perhaps they're getting wrong is that each medium is being thought to be delivering a certain number. And what is being missed in that is, are we using the medium, thinking our brand, and using the medium to connect with the consumer, thinking their brand strategy, and how best each medium can be used to do that. And there will be some brands which will find print better, maybe. There'll be some which might find digital. But I think the missing link is everyone's really just thinking maybe cost and cost per reach, but not really brand strategy. And the one thing that I think everyone should be thinking of is, what are you doing to get your long-term emotional connect with your consumers right? And maybe if that's the question that gets put up more in boardrooms and in media conversations, these other questions might, I dare say, sort themselves
but
out
do,
of them.
Do you think, I mean, any of you can take this, do you think people are only measuring reach or CPRPs? Because if you take an example, let's take the example we were talking about, sport of the Indian Premier League. Look at the reach and look at the figures of IPL when it started. If it was 7 then, it's about 2 or 3 now. But the support is still there. What it therefore tells you is that there is latent support for the idea, the concept, the impact. If you even look at stuff like news, it's not measured on reach at all. It's measured on impact and perception of the brand. When an FMCG advertises on a news channel, they're looking at impact, visibility of a brand. Let's talk about that. Let's talk about the possibility of brands to start conversations. In today's day and age on digital media, does print start a conversation? Does digital alone start a conversation? Or does television start a conversation on social media? That is where the advertiser will see value. So can I just challenge this notion that advertisers are getting it wrong? Because I don't think advertisers are only looking anymore at all at CPRPs or pure numbers. Otherwise, the story of IPL, FMCGs or news channels would be completely different. But it's not. So would anyone like to take that up?
Okay, I think large part of the business, particularly from the FMCG background where Puneet is coming from, is bought on a day-to-day basis on CPRP. And that's where the most of the news channels and maybe some niche channels are getting marginalized. The kind of, if I look at the TRP rating, just go by the CPRP standards, any show in the evening on prime time delivers 0.1%, 0.01% of the total audience. But you walk in this room, or walk anywhere, go in any part of the country and you ask them, do you recognize this particular anchor? I'm talking about 4 or 5 top anchors of this country. You call them in the room, the crowd will be moving towards that. That's how the consumer, in any sample size, you will see a consumer behavior as to what they are actually looking for. Unfortunately, as per the data and the set standards, because most of the marketeers, I'm sorry to say this, are not ready to take the punt. They only take punt where there is a stature. So IPL is more about stature. That you are going to watch a match with Shah Rukh Khan.
As might be digital.
But putting a money on a show where you are debating about whether the voters' right is only to meet their representative at the time of election, or should the representative be seen there in any constituency every Sunday, and you raise a debate, you get 10,000 phone calls on a show, but advertisers are not interested to put money there because the rating percentage is low. So large part of that, what advertisers is missing here is that if you associate with such cause, products, you build your brand much longer than what it is.
Shiva? If I may just supplement. See, the question is of measurement. And and advertising as a profession, if you go back to history, started with the principle of right brain. It's a very creative function. It's all about experience. It's all about touch and feel. It's all about engaging an audience. And today, when an audience engages with any medium, be it print, digital, they're not looking at numbers. They're engaging with something which gives them joy, which gives them pleasure. Now, if you convert this business, which is an art, into a science and reduce it to the least common denominator of numbers, TRPs, and this, you are obviously bound to get it wrong. You have to bring back the romance of the creativity. You have to bring back the engagement of the audience. Whichever medium, each medium has its innate appeal. It has a native appeal, and it has certain strength. Now, how the brand itself and the advertisers, how do they collaborate? And with the power of technology, technology is a power. I don't like to call it digital. And which can be applied to every medium. How do you apply that? And how do you move away from making it a, you know, what I call the least common denominator of measurement? Don't make it a victim of TRPs, numbers, or readership, or, but how do you manage to engage more? And how do you manage to bring back the, what we call, romance of each of the medium and get back the advertisers' engagement or the consumers' engagement?
Can you tell me how that would apply in print? So you're saying if the Indian Express is more arty, it would work more, it's a better advertising proposition than... Are you talking of brand solutions?
No, one is...
Are you talking of numbers or are you talking of brand solutions?
I'm not talking about brand solutions. There are two things. Again, obviously the brands themselves have a responsibility. The for example, whether it's Indian Express or the Times of India, they have a responsibility of... anything has to be relevant to the context. If you are not relevant and not contextual, and if you are not able to deliver what the audience is expecting you to deliver, then you will obviously go out of context. So first is the brand's own positioning and its own investment. And they create an environment. Obviously, the print strength today is the curated content, because internet has a lot of clutter, and how do you break through the clutter? And I don't want to go into that space. Once you have created a positioning for yourself, then how do you work with the advertisers to help them engage their consumers, which you are delivering for your products or service?
Okay, put in
fact, just add to that a little bit. One of the biggest factors of consideration for marketers today has to be that the creative thinking for print has become a subset or a derivative of television thinking. Now, perhaps that is driven by the fact that television is quote-unquote more sexy. It is seen as more audiovisual. But the fact is, when you are spending 40% of your $8 billion advertising spend in India on print, and you're not giving enough with your creative agencies, you're not investing enough time and effort in coming up with the right kind of creative that speaks to the audience in the context in which your content is being presented, then you are, you know, missing the bushes for the forest. And the second point that I wanted to actually take on from what Shiva was saying, that it's all about art and it's not about science. Actually, there is a little bit of science in it as well, and there is a little bit of numbers in it as well. But when you look at how the numbers are being read today, the legacy thinking of print planning and media planning continues to prevail. You know, for lack of measurement or measurement being available or not, the fact is that there are media plans on which there is no fresh thinking going beyond the traditional entrenched positions that are there, and that is because of the fact that the marketers are not really willing to step out and look at beyond the metrics connect that a print newspaper or any publication has on the ground. Most print organizations today run larger CSR and audience connect, I mean, you could call it CSR, you could call it reader connect initiatives, which are actually appealing to the audience at a ground level, whether it is women, youth, community, and social work that they're doing. But all of these are seen as disjointed activities from the objectives that the brand have. And there is a natural marriage of the two. However, the process of intermediation ensures that any such initiative that a print group is running actually does not really travel up to the client and, you know, gets filtered on in the process. And I think we are, as media, equally responsible.
I came to Mumbai in 2004. And when I came to Mumbai, the TV guys would speak like you're speaking.
That's nice to know.
And the digital guys were not there.
Good, so now we have both.
You know, believe me, and they would say, you don't understand, we have focused audiences, we're doing a lot of work, we, you know, we're reaching out to you, we are giving creative solutions, we are doing this, we're doing that. And, you know, the print guys would say, stop complaining.
So we've learned, I guess.
You know, the question therefore is, and I would give you a factual counter to what you're saying. Let's say, I will not name brands, but let's say sports. HD on sport. Measure the size of the audience. It's small. Find out what are the rates that are being asked for by some of those channels who have upcoming sports events, and people willing to bite into that. Now, what that means is that the sports channels are putting an investment into the future, and there are people out there who are willing to put not bite-sized but chunk-sized bites of that sport, which are not delivering you pure numbers. How can you therefore then say that advertisers are not seeing it through? There is behind all of this, there's an imaginative planner, there's a keen advertiser who's seeing it through and saying, I'm making an investment into maybe the quality of the audience, the nature of the audience, the segmentation of the audience. So I think, you know, how do you...
So it's a fair point, Arnab.
These are the same people who will also deal with print.
Not really. Actually, that's where the gap is. Today, you ask any marketer or any media agency which is there, is it the same planner who works on television, who works on digital, who works on print? Absolutely not. Except perhaps at an apex level. And that's the reality of our business. And in fact, print is not sexy. Not enough planners and buyers today want to get into print because they see it as a legacy medium that's going to die because there's so much hype around it. And yet the industry continues to spend close to 18,000 crores every year, going as much market share as television does year after year.
That's what they did on New York Times 10 years back.
Well, so US is always cited as an example of what went wrong with print. And this has been going on for the last decade and a half. I'm not saying that that's an inevitability that's not being read on the wall. But the fact of the matter is that as the size of audiences are increasing, even today there are enough and more media dark areas where despite all the connectivity, all the power availability, all the channels, national footprint through British or any others, the marketers are not able to reach that audience, and print continues to door deliver information and content to those audiences. Yeah, extremely relevant, and marketers, the sooner they realize that and the larger time they spend on it, they will actually be able to take value out of it. If they don't, it will still continue to be relevant to an audience. Because I'm telling you, we are here trying to solve the problems for a marketer or tell them what they are doing wrong. But the fact is, as a publication, as a press group, our primary accountability is to the reader. As long as we are true to the reader, delivering content that they want and being relevant in their life by bringing them information, we will always have an economic basis for being in this business.
Okay, well, I have a simple one-liner, sorry. Simple one-liner. See, digital screens, so I can say, digital screens are becoming smaller and smaller. So all consumption electronically will get into smaller and smaller. Soon you will start watching television on your watches. Human ego is becoming bigger and bigger. And only out of home and print, the large place jackets can get, whether it's you're selling a product, whether you're selling a politician, whether you're a godman, anything are larger than life. Anything which is larger than life and which can enter your bedroom is print. And as long as print is able to enter, do that. And as long as you have the full page jacket, print is not going anywhere. Digital and have to worry, because when you get into smaller screens, I don't know what will happen to this.
Shiva, I like you. I tell you, Shiva, I really like you. You know, we go back a very long way, my friend. Who's reading? This country, you see after Jio, I challenge your basic assumption. Wake up. People are watching. The future is video. Video consumption driven by crashing bandwidth costs and a younger population. And you're standing there as the bulwark saying people will not watch. People hate. The screens are small. They're not attention grabbing. But 5 years from now, people are only going to be watching. Right? Now that's a demographic fact. As keen as the fact that India is urbanizing twice as faster as we thought it would. As clear as the fact that the figures on DTH 10 years back were supposed to be, one third of what had been predicted. And I know so many people who scoffed at DTH players 10 years back, but in India, we remember the BlackBerry came after it launched in the US, and you're the biggest tech geek, And we dumped the BlackBerry quicker than it was dumped in the US. The rate of change and accelerated social change in India is massive. The future is video. So please answer in that context. Are you saying that is not going to happen?
No.
It's because what advertisers want is attention.
Yeah.
See, it's really nice for me to sit here and see you guys defend print, and I'm just enjoying this conversation.
Welcome to the world. And we are doing it for the last 20 years. And we'll do it for the next 20. So, undoubtedly the consumer engagement has become multidimensional. And whether you engage with WhatsApp, and half the people in the room must be obviously engaging with WhatsApp. Breaking news. Whether Shashikala got convicted, all of us received in WhatsApp, no doubt about it. And immediately, if we have access to television, we'll tune to the television. But have you skipped reading it in the next day morning? And I always tell my team that the day the kid goes to school with an electronic screen, that is the day I have to be worried about print. Till that time, the way our brains are wired, the way we consume each medium and the way it registers, and I'm sure half the people in the room will have Kindles. or electronic thing, but we all consume books in the physical format. And when you consume something in the physical format, the way it registers, way we imbibe, and the way we pause, think, and create is very different the way we interact with other mediums.
Shiva, nostalgia is a very bad business model. Would you agree? Simple statement. Nostalgia is a bad business model.
Absolutely.
Would you agree?
Absolutely.
But you're talking about nostalgia.
No, but I'm talking of how our brains are wired. And that is an integral part of how we'll react to each medium. I'm not saying that each medium. Back to my earlier point, that you have to develop the innate ability of the medium and able to capitalize it.
Okay.
Let me just add one thing.
The debate is not with me.
I know the debate is not with you, but I just want to add one thing which I think the audience may not be aware of. How many of you know which are the top 5 newspapers of the world just by way of circulation and which countries they come from? Does anybody know? Give me the top 3 of the world, top 3 newspapers of the world. They all, by number of circulation, they all come from the same country. Can anybody name that country? Japan. The most digitally aware, digitally historically aware, the most digital savvy audience with all kinds of IoT, M2M connect and all kinds of devices being available, everybody needs newspaper. I'm not here holding a candle for print and saying that, you know, oh, it has to survive because my job is at stake there. No. What I'm saying is any medium that continues to be relevant to the audience that it reaches out to will have survival. And as a medium, as we evolve, if we are able to carry marketers as well, we will have a business model. Today, the marketers are just reading the epitaph of print and not realizing the innate strength that a medium like print has in terms of the audience reach out that it has. Today, the women's communities and the youth communities that we connect to in the manner in which we're connected to, and I'm not talking about just my publication, every single regional media group in the country has a brilliant access to these audiences, and there are marketers who are leveraging that, and there are marketers who are not. I am saying there is a case for those marketers who are not leveraging it to make use of it. That's it.
You know, Sam made a very good point during his presentation in the morning today, that while data is a direction, that's not the only thing advertiser should look at. And on all, whether there is a print, digital, print is less, digital and television, where more and more innovations you do and spot an opportunity, that's what many advertisers today are missing at. Advertisers are looking at opportunity, as you rightly said, but they're not looking at all the opportunities that they can explore because of the fixed set of standards. And I spoke to a very senior guy in Unilever, and I said the way Unilever is buying, long back, I'm talking about 2 years ago, is buying, according to me, fundamentally, it's wrong, and it needs to improve. You know?
So look, I'm not going to comment on that. Very difficult in my position to comment on that.
Because everything, all the purchases cannot happen only through the prism of CPL. And the moment you step out of that, there is a huge opportunity. There are clients who advertise basis whether their dealer, distributor are telling him that this is the brand which is going to work. That works for newspaper, that works for television. This is a particular program that I think works. And that's gut feel of a common man on the street, which works for many advertising brands. Counting day on elections. The same news channels where no advertiser is ready to pay whatever money, they're ready to pay 30 times, 50 times, and it's full. That's an opportunity that advertiser has addressed. Right now, in the Mumbai municipal elections, a lot of clients are running brand activation activity on the news channels. That's an opportunity that we are talking about, which we can leverage as a media brand, which has a far... Patanjali, okay, yeah. I mean, but look at one client who has built his brand only through news channels. Then one single client on my group company is higher than the entire spend of Group M. And what he is doing, he's going by his gut. He's saying, look, people are buying and consuming the product. If I advertise here, I become from, and he was giving an example of a Tamil Nadu based, Tamil news channel. He says in Tamil Nadu, we were 50 crore before we started advertising. He bought a Hindu and he bought a news channel. He said, next month I was 100 crore in 1 month. This is what the change and the gut feel of what Sam spoke about. The data, he went by data. Hindu is the largest circulating newspaper.
I'm reminded of something which apparently Winston Churchill said. That statistics gets used as a drunk man uses a lamppost, more for support than illumination. And maybe that does hold true sometimes in the way it's getting done. If I just step back, you know, really what's happening in the mind of the advertiser is an interesting conversation to have before we look at the decisions that get taken. Because that's really where it might just throw some different light. So there are three or four things that I think happen. The first is the tyranny of the quarter. We all know it, it happens. There is a point of view of the short term, that's something which weighs on the mind. The second is what I call the dance of digital. The question that gets asked is, how much money have you spent on digital? Really a wrong question if you're thinking strategy and planning, probably a different question should be asked. The third really is what I call the roar of the ROI. Everyone wants to know the ROI, and that's a good question to ask, but that ROI has one problem. It is a short-term measure. You cannot look at ROI beyond maybe a quarter or two, so it drives those decisions. And finally, the curse of the CPRP, which is a big conversation, because of course it's important. But I think if you look at just these four, they weigh heavily on the mind of the advertiser at any point of time. And that does lead to then some decisions which happen a certain way. I think what probably needs to be thought of, and I think it got discussed here, is that, you know, brands get built over time, they get built over building the emotional connect, they get built over understanding how you are starting to mean something more than just, you know, the 10 second or 30 second. And that's where if the medium and the message together starts to be looked at to build that emotional connect, I think many of the opportunities that you're talking about, they will be, that will be one difference that we will see. So that's one thing that at least I, in my little experience, I think is missing. And that's where maybe the thing you said 10 years ago, people used to think about how do you integrate your brand into content. And I'll give you another interesting experience I had.
Yeah.
First time I was going for consumer home visits after I joined Zee, I was told that it's going to be a 2-hour group. And I nearly fell off the chair because for all my 20 years, whenever I did a group, you know, if you did 45 minutes talking of shampoo or soap, people were already disconnected. And here, it was scheduled to be 2 hours. I go there, I sit for 2 hours. At the end of 2 hours, I have consumers who are talking about soaps, characters, stories, and they could go on for another two. So here is a group of people who's really very, very deeply connected with whatever happens on TV. Good, bad, ugly, we all have a point of view. Now, if brands could think of how you can leverage this deep emotional connect, which seems to perhaps be a bit more than the connect that maybe a soap or a shampoo may have today, we can really create something which is much more powerful. At least that's something which seems like a lost opportunity, and maybe something which we as broadcasters need to give that solution, and advertisers perhaps need to see value in it, and then maybe things might be different.
No, Puneet, just to add to that, I think people also have faith in what they like. People have faith in values, people have faith in change, people have faith in brands, people support what they believe in. And I think the softer aspects of a brand, what we call the softer aspects, not just the pure numbers, are therefore becoming increasingly, absolutely, what you've just said, what people identify with, they will watch and they will advertise. You can't take that link away from the creation of any brand. That's been my experience in the creation of Republic also. But having said that, I think we are at an inflection point. India is changing much quicker in technology, and the youth and the age of our population is going to make that switch bigger. I've often said, Puneet, that you look at the millennial becoming the principal wage earner, the child born in 1995, who's presumably 21 or 22 years now, is getting out of college, maybe getting a professional degree. 5 years from now will be the person taking key decisions on whether they want to read a paper, buy a paper, subscribe to a paper, or watch a screen, or watch a screen and watch TV. That's the millennial coming of age. It could happen anywhere between 2 to 4 years from now, in my opinion. That's the time when the advertisers also will have to look at the numbers in India. 300 to 400 million smartphones. Massive amounts of video consumption, 750 to 800 connected consumers out there. That's when the game begins to change. And that's when the static medium of the present might just quickly change quicker than we think. I mean, so I agree with all that you said, and don't get me wrong, Shiva, but there's a context to our population, which we cannot deny. We are the youngest population below the age of 30. And they're changing very fast. So I just wanted to add that as a thought. Any?
No, I completely agree with you. In fact, the point of inflection when there is ubiquitous data connectivity and content in local Indian languages. You can't take a Google or a Yahoo or a Facebook and translate everything that is being published in different dialects of Punjabi and Marathi and Gujarati and give the same sense to the audience that is living in those towns. And for a lot of them, English is not the lingua franca. There are enough and more regional language senses that they have.
Okay.
And we need to be able to cater to
them. I agree with Arnab. The more and more content will get consumed.
I like the interruptions. I just love them. Yeah. I have missed them so much. Thank you, my friend. The blood rush is coming back, sir.
If you look at the Prime Minister's speech in the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, which was done during the day, more and more people consumed it on their mobile phone later on. Because once the conversation started happening on social media, they went on the YouTube, on different channel websites, and they started watching it. At least about over a million times was watched on my app itself. That is the power of the new medium, and that's where the advertisers, when they are doing this structured deal in the market, when you are buying spots, they can always bundle the deal with the content that is streaming on the different platforms,
yeah.
And that's where the power is going.
So, if I may respond, say digital is certainly a disruptor, no doubt about it. It's not only a disruptor for media, but obviously for every sector. In fact, banking as a sector is getting disrupted. Every niche is getting disrupted. You take any sector today, they're all getting disrupted by digital. And what has digital done? Right from 2006 onwards, if you see, every couple of years, it is resetting the market. The base is getting reset. The cost is going down. Beyond the point, and as somebody said, I think you said that each of the client that advertises has to look at his quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, quarter four. What is his top line? What is his cost to service the top line? And advertising is a key element of that cost. Now, as digital is resetting the cost base, it's up to you that your cost base may no longer be affordable to deliver that value. So you have to constantly relook at it. So how do you embrace technology to look at your cost and bring it down? And that obviously will address most of the points you made. Whether it be at CPRC, whether it be at ratings, be it leadership, most of it. So undoubtedly the cost has to come down. In addition to how do you creatively engage it? These are the two elements I wanted to add.
Put it quickly.
I think maybe the cost conversation is the wrong conversation, honestly. Because the conversation needs to be value. And I know, as marketers, everyone talks about that. And there is strong questions being asked, for example, even on digital, we know that does it deliver the value that, 20% spend going there, but actually the world's biggest advertisers starting to ask, is it effective? The Procter says that, Unilever says that today. And it goes back to the same question. Are we delivering brand value? Are we doing whatever medium spends? Is it leading to something which builds the brand equity? Versus delivering the number for the uplift for the quarter or a click-through rate and so on. So I think the conversation, and I think it's incumbent upon us to start that, honestly. What is the value that we can bring back to the advertiser? The question is, if I, let's say, can offer to the advertiser through more technology, a very sharply focused, this is what I deliver in terms of your target group, so many millions, even through TV, not just digital. And by the way, we can connect them to you through a very different emotional connect. That's the kind of thing I think we first need to take back to the advertiser. Otherwise, honestly, why should they change on the conversation on cost?
Okay, so Puneet, Pradeep, Avinash, Shiva, great talking to all of you. It's been, it's a good churn. We've had a great chat. You want some questions from the audience, Sam? Yes? So somebody's going to do the rounds, take the mic around. We have some time for questions, yeah? Sure.
Okay.
Anyone wants questions, yeah? So you got a mic moving around? Okay. So I'll moderate this. Okay. No problem.
This is, by the way, so far the finest debate that happened in the last 6 months, where Arnav has spoken only 5 times.
You've been counting, eh?
Oh, man.
Why are you undervaluing your charm and charisma? It's because of you and him and us.
Don't worry, Avinash. Republic has not launched yet. Your worry will be after we launch. Okay. Let's get some questions in. Mr. Behta, yeah, come on.
Oh, thank you, Arnab. Great to see you after a long time. Absolute honor.
Great.
I have a question for Mr. Shiva. Pardon me to ask you, sir. How do you see press media in the next 5 years, and how would you like to, what would be your strategy to combat that situation in terms of the print media? Thank you.
I'm sure that everybody in the audience have the morning tea. That we are not stopped having morning tea because we get up and start checking our WhatsApp. So the point here is morning habits, in a sense, will change, but are very difficult to break. And see, your point is that in the next 5 years, how print as a medium will be. And our job as the brand custodians is to see that how do we improve the, how do we differentiate ourselves? Obviously, we lost two things very clearly. We lost the ability to do breaking news. We also lost the ability to serve search, which is the classified. And these are the two categories which are seeing a decline. But at the same time, what are our strengths and how do we play to our strength? And tell me which medium today, when you're consuming it, it's, let us say, even 30 minutes or 30 minutes of uninterrupted consumption without any distraction, whether of your phone, whether of television, of any of the medium, it's print. Now tell me what value or what measurement you will attribute to that. That 30 minutes of engagement is of certain value to the advertiser. And this, which is what print will continue to capitalize on. And I see next 5 years is certainly not a challenge, nor next 10 years. There will be a secular decline, but the creativity with which we engage and how we leverage the advertisement ecosystem is what will sustain the future of print.
Yeah. Okay, sir, please go ahead, right here. Can the mic come?
Arnab, after Conclave, your Republic, you know, things are put together. It's looking good now. Thank Congratulations
you.
For that.
Thank you.
Yeah. So I have a question for you, Arnab.
I'm a moderator.
No. But then there's a question for you. Now that Republic is going to get launched, are you and Vivek promising to Mr. Shiva and Mr. Pradeep that you're not going to take any ads on those newspapers, and you're not going to take any other, you know, big holdings on Natural Road, and you'll only use digital media and television?
That's a great question, actually. You'll be happy to know, when we launched on Twitter, we got 10,000 followers in 30 minutes. We got 100,000 in a week, not one bit of content we put out. I'm not saying that they don't matter. I'm doing fine. So it tells you a story. We've existed only on digital and we're not on TV yet. What we will prove via Republic is that the future is TV and digital. We'll prove that. Now you're saying, are you going to be completely independent on print? Well, I'm happy if they want to collaborate, but you're telling me, do I need them? The answer is no. The answer is no.
When you launch, are you going to use
them? I'm telling you this. I'm telling you, do I need them? The answer is no. I'm telling you with that confidence, I'm a TV digital person. The future is TV digital. We'll connect 3 years from now. We can match who goes where.
The way we are seated today is...
But I like Shiva. There's no problem with Shiva. Shiva, this is
the
not personal.
The way we are seated today, it's evident that print always have to flank. Digital and television.
I just like to add one more thing. You know, I mean, there's
the
no need
English
to
or the language.
No, no, but I like to be trying to start a nice quarrel here. You can take my job. No problem.
No, actually, just one thing I'd like to add. We don't need to get emotional about sustainability of a medium. We are not here to defend print, and you know, if that's an appearance, then it's perhaps incorrect. I think as marketers, a sustainability of a business is a completely different thing. But whether print lives or dies is not the question here. As long as media organizations, we have a way to connect to that audience, whether it is television, print, digital, OTT, applications that are beyond digital in the traditional sense of social media, etc. You know, there are enough and more ways of connecting with that audience. And if we remain relevant to that audience through newer means, we will obviously deliver value to the advertiser. I'm not too worried about print dying 5 years later or 7 years later. We actually did a juxtaposition of everything that Wall Street Journal and New York Times went over 15 years, mapped each and every point of inflection that they faced with respect to our organization, and actually could see a predictability. I know it's a heuristic model, but we saw 7 to 10 years plateauing of print, and beyond that, a clear decline. assuming there's no cataclysmic event that happens, like a USO fund suddenly being deployed to create Wi-Fi connectivity across the country, which the government has not done in the last 20 years, I doubt if they're going to do it in the next 10 years.
Okay, we got the mic.
Sir, I have a question.
Sorry.
My question is, what advertisers are getting wrong? I still haven't heard that. So please tell us, what are they getting wrong?
I'm on your side.
You're not.
You figured that by now.
You're not.
If I can quickly answer that, as I had also mentioned, there are two things. See, increasingly the world is moving to regulation, compliance, data, science, and all. So the limited point is, if you get into the compliant mode, you will definitely get it wrong. There has to be a little dribble in you. There has to be something different. If you just do what others are doing, you will definitely get it wrong. If you have to create an impact, create a difference, be different. As simple as that. Yes, get the rules, get the numbers, get all the data, facts, everything is fine. But go as per your gut feel. And that's your innate gut feel, which ultimately, if you see, differentiate every successful person, as Arnab himself is going to do, he has a gut feel. He has taken those risks. And without risks,
thank you,
you cannot be successful.
Thank you, sir.
And that's a risk he has taken. That is a risk each one of us have to take if you need to succeed.
Thank you. Thank you, Shiva, for that. Thank you very much.
On what she asked and also what Puneet keeps repeating about emotional connect. So what will Republic do very differently to bring that emotional connect? And I know that you're not going to get into political funding, etc., so the politician is out. But in terms of brands, in terms of the nation building, etc., how will you do that differently?
All that I have done is only connect. And we connect at a very deep level. In the last 1 year, we connected with people when we did a campaign called Right to Pray. We stood against what we saw as defunct religious practices. And we said, why should women not enter Hajian? Why should not they not enter Shani Shignapur? And why should they not enter Sabrimala? And we said we stand against everyone, including religious orthodoxy. And people saw us step out there and take what Shiva calls the risk. That is connect. So when you say whether I win or lose, I will connect because this is my belief. It also links up to the question, the advertiser is looking at the connect with your audience, not just the size. Everybody can throw numbers at you. But does the audience believe in it? So I think belief is what we ride on, and I'm not pitching, but I can tell you this, that even before the launch, people want us on it. That's only because of heart-to-heart connect with people, you know. And I will not use this forum as a pitch for Republic, it won't be fair, but since you asked me the question, those who are in our business today, who are seeing what we do, who say independent media must be there, you must go out there, you must win, and you must fight, no, it's only because we've already told people what we do for 10 years. We've taken on terrorists, we've taken on corruption, we've taken on orthodoxy. There's nothing we've left. It's all the residue of that support that we get into this venture. And it's beautiful. I've never felt more blessed than with the support we are receiving. But there was a question there.
I just wanted to add, best of luck, that you are going digital and therefore you feel that print, may not be required. That depends on the media planning. But let me add, and he's from Z. We have all the channels, literally, right? When it comes to an impact, when it comes to value, when it comes to a launch, right? The print naturally is used. Now, whether it is used in what proportion, as Shiva mentioned and the panel is saying, that you may have a proportionate to TV and all, but it is all used. So the guy with a Z network, like Puneet is here, the reach is tremendous because he has fantastic network. Star has got fantastic network. In spite of that, the value of print and the kind of impact, and as you rightly mentioned, is so much that the print is still used, and what Shiva means is a jacket or for impact, is there. So in spite of so much of reach and audience engagement, print is not ignored, and I don't think it will be ignored in future. That's what I wanted to add. So I would urge you to look at print and not go digital for your launch.
Are you pitching? Are you giving it?
I'm just telling you that life without print is difficult. I'm only suggesting you, it's up to you to take it or not.
Dropping a hint.
Thank you, my friend. Thank you. Any more questions coming in? This is a great evening.
Okay.
We got a question there. Hi.
Hi. I'm an advertiser. I do advertise for luggage. One of the things that I think the answer to that particular line that's behind you, which is the advertiser getting long, and I think Shiva already said, is every brand has a reason to advertise. Okay? And we have also heard that television is going to be out of fashion because digital is going to take over. I'm telling you, as long as live sports is there, television will never go out of fashion. Similarly, press works very well when there is an offer. Okay, so if it's Amazon, who is in e-com, whether it's Snapdeal, if they have an offer, they have to come to press. Similarly, as far as the branding is, brand building is concerned, television will always remain a medium. So what is that? What the advertiser goes wrong is when he tries to do what everybody else is doing. I have a brand which gives a lot of offer. I have a brand called Alpha, okay? I always use print. But when it comes to a brand like Carlton, I would obviously probably use television to brand it. So every medium will stay, and it will stay because every medium is needed. And, you know, we have also started hearing that television is going to die. I don't think television is going to die. So advertisers have to understand why they are advertising and accordingly choose the medium. And that's how it's going to be.
Absolutely. I think we have time for a couple of more questions, Sam. We wrap up.
Just one more point, Anam, if you don't mind. There are two. No, I think the core question is, what is that advertiser have to do different? I'll take Arnab as an example. Two things he did different. When he joined us, he changed the definition of evening news. We were all used to watching that news the way it was, but he changed the whole format.
Thank you.
And today that has set a new trend, and every channel is following it. The second thing he's doing, obviously, is taking his risk and doing something on his own, which is the second. So the question is that we cannot go in the safety of numbers. So these are, I guess, these two, he himself is an example, two great way of saying that what is that we need to do different if you have to be successful.
So Shiva, you're going to be you're going to be watching Republic TV over any other channel day one, right?
I must confess that I only read print. I didn't watch Arnab when he was doing Times Now. Now I will be watching the public, but I will definitely be watching you.
Oh, thank you, Shiva. Thank you, Shiva. This has been lovely. It's a meeting of friends. I feel so happy. I think we had a great conversation. Thank you very much, Sam and Vikram, for calling us here. It was wonderful. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Sure. I'm going to request a panel member.